Hello, dear students. In today's class, I teach you some more programming examples on for loop. In the last class, I taught what is for. For is one of the counter controlled loop. It also repeats the given block of statements repeatedly. If the given condition is true, it repeats. Whenever the condition becomes false, it will not repeat. That is what we studied in the last class. In today's class, I teach you only examples on for. First example, whichever I explained in my last class, that is to print 1 to 10 numbers. It is a very simple program. As we know already, for has three parts: first part, second part, third part. And this is what the body of for. How it works, I explained. I repeat once again for you. Always the first part works for the first time. Always the first part works for the first time only once. That means 1 will be stored in the I variable first. After second part will be checked for true or false. 1 is less than equals to 10. If it is true, then the body works. That means 1 is less than equals to 10. Yes, 1 will be printed. Afterwards, third part works. I equals to I plus 1. That means I becomes 2. 2 less than equals to 10. Yes. Again third part. 3. 3 less than equals to 10. Yes. 4. 4 less than equals to 10. Yes. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. It becomes 11. 11 less than equals to 10. No. For is over. Program is completed. This is what I explained to you in my last class. First part works only once for the first time. Then the second one works. That will be checked for true or false. If it is true, repetitive process starts. Then third part works. Afterwards, the second will be worked. Again, if it is true, body, third, second, true, body, second, true, body, third, second, body, third, second, body. Whenever second becomes false, loop stops. This is what the working of for. Very good. I explain you the next example. Okay, next program is very simple one and interesting. Write a C program to display multiple table of y. I hope you understood. What is the question? Write a C program to display multiple table of 5. Multiple table of 5 means 5 1s are 5, 5 2s are 10, 5 3s are 15, 5 4s are 20, till 5 10s are 50. This is what multiple table of 5. You write the program. What is the logic behind this given problem? Just you need to multiply the number 5 with 1 to 10 numbers. What is the logic? Multiply the number 5 with 1 to 10 numbers. 5 into 1, 5. 5 into 2, 10. 5 into 3, 15. Just multiply. If you want the multiple table of 7, multiply 7 with 1 to 10 numbers. If you want to get the multiple table of any value, multiply that value with 1 to 10 numbers. That is what the logic. Just only I taught you how to print 1 to 10 numbers. See here. First time I will be 1. 1 less than equals to 10. I means 1, 2, 3. It is generating 1 to 10 numbers. What I am doing here? Just I am multiplying 5 with 1 to 10 numbers. See here. 5 ones are 5 into 1 first time. 5. I becomes 2. 2 less than equals to 10. 5 twos are 10. 5 threes are 15. I hope you understood. First time I will be 1. 1 less than equals to 10. Yes. 5 into 1, 5. I becomes 2. 2 less than equals to 10? Yes. 5 into 2, 10. I becomes 3. 3 less than equals to 10? Yes. 5 into 3, 15. 5 into 4, like that it prints up to 5 into 10, 50. It generates or it prints the multiple table of 5. I hope you understood. Very simple and interesting program. I explain you the next one. Okay, just only I explained to you how to print multiple table of 5. But now what is the question? Write a C program to display multiple table of n. Oh my god. You are asking user to enter the value of n. Okay. Whatever the user enters, that multiple table. Then what is the logic? Multiply n only with 1 to 10 numbers. Very simple thing. Just I am reading n here. Enter n. Whatever the n we enter that will be stored in n. That n only we multiply. Assume that n entered by me is 7. Let us assume. Then 7 into 1, 7. 7 2 is 14. 7 3 is 21. 7 10 is 70. Means multiple table of 7 will be printed. If you enter 17, we get multiple table of 17. If you enter 30, multiple table of 30. Whatever the value we enter, that multiple table only we get. First, I explained you how to print 1 to 10. Afterwards, I explained you how to print multiple table of 5. Now, I explained you how to print multiple table of n. Oh, very good. You are improving. Okay, here I did mistake. I must be small. Okay. Next program, I explain. Next problem is also very simple. Write a C program to display multiple table of n. Oh, same question. No. One change is there. To display multiple table of n in multiple table format. Oh my god. Then what is multiple table format? See here. 7 into 1 equals to 7. 7 into 2 equals to 14. 7 into 3 equals to 21. 7 into 10 equals to 70. This is what you have to print. Then which logic we use? Which logic we use? We print n also. What is this 777? N only. What are these 1, 2, 3, 4? I value. What are these third value? Multiplied value. See here. This is n value into I value equals to n into I value. See here. First I am printing n. Next I am printing I. Last I am printing n into I. But here I need one capital X which represents into. Then I need one equals to. See here. How many times percentage do I used? 1, 2nd, 3rd. Oh, this first is for n. Oh, very good. Second is for I. Oh, very good. Last is for n into I. Very good. This x we need in between. It's printing. We need equals to also. It's printing. Yes, work done. Like that, why can't you develop apps? Like this only software are going to develop. Apps will be there in the mobile. But that how to develop is different. But the logic remains same, no? Logic is very important for the industry. To which industry you are working. That's what, try to improve your logic. Thank you. I hope you understood. Then just what you have to do, we need one extra variable here. I helps us to generate the numbers. N is to store n value. Then we are reading n. Just we are printing the multiple table of n in multiple table format. I hope you understood. Very good.